No one would have believed in the earliest days of the 21st century that men would consider the possibility of living on other planets. And yet across the gulfs of Mexico, Persia, and Thailand, minds immeasurably superior to ours regarded the red planet with envious eyes. And slowly and surely, they sent their probes to get there.
Come on, Pillinger. Giddy up, Beagle 2. Not long now, girl.
The chances of anything getting to Mars are a million to one, they said. The chances of anything getting to Mars are a million to one. But still, they've gone.
Probes went up from Cape Canaveral, UAE and China, and hope for our deliverance from a world turning to poo. We learned more about the planet, humanity uniting to move up to Mars.
The yellow sun was fading when the probes arrived, and humans started coming here. Mars used to be such a nice planet. Now mankind's here. Now mankind's
here. Watching The Hughes at 10 with me, the gorgeous Hugh Edwards. Why? Because I'm worth it. After Larry the Cat's 10th anniversary at 10 Downing Street, officials have revealed that he actually left 2 years ago, but wanted to come straight back in again.
Well, what would you like to drink, sir?
Oh, hello. Yes, I'm the local Ofsted inspector. Can you tell me where the Margaret Thatcher Emporium for Further Education is, please?
This is it.
Well, according to the sign outside, this is a pub called the Old Trout.
Ah, no. That went out of business. No. We reopened as an emporium of learning and culture. So what's your poison then, Gov?
Sorry?
Good to see you here. I'm the headmaster. Excuse me a second. Right, class, I want a 500-word essay on why Brian Clough was the greatest England manager we'd ever had. Right, now, what can I do you for?
Well, I have reason to believe that this is not a place of education at all, just a thinly veiled attempt to prematurely open a pub.
How dare you? Let me prove you wrong. Right, Tucker, over there, what is 8 parts rum, 2 parts lime and some crushed ice? What does that make?
Daiquiri, sir.
Oh, impressive. Although I must say, he doesn't look like he's of a school age.
Oh no, kids today, eh? God, they all look so grown up, don't they?
He's got a beard.
He's an early developer.
It's grey.
Not so loud. He's very sensitive about it.
Oh, right you are. Okay, sorry. Carry on with your lesson. I'll just observe.
Right, okay. Blimey. All right then, everyone. Let's look at today's specials. The blackboard. Who could tell me what 3 gammon chips, one cheeseburger and a lasagna make? Yeah? Hey? Yeah?
Food poisoning.
Oi! 100 lines. I must read the food hygiene certificate. I want it done by closing time. Home time.
Well, I must say, it's very encouraging to see so many of your pupils reading reference books, Headmaster.
Headmaster? What? Oh, it's me. Yeah. Well, we're getting ready for the pub quiz, you know. I mean exams. Yeah.
One question. Why is there a fruit machine in the corner?
Oh, that. It's actually a computer that teaches kids about probability and getting your 3 fruit and veg a day.
Shouldn't it be 5?
We'll work it up to that.
Okay, but how does a jukebox fit into the curriculum?
Hmm? Right, oh yeah, well, history, isn't it? I mean, you won't find a track that's recorded after 1987 on there.
Okay, so where did you graduate from, Headmaster?
Would you believe it? The University of Life.
Drive nuts on the bar?
boxes of crisps behind the counter, and a full range of cask ales on tap. Own up, you're running a pub.
No, 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 we're school.
And I suppose this is the school bell?
Lost orders, ladies and gentlemen. Last one, you've got...
Thought so. £2,000 fine.
Bollocks.
Downing Street have said there was a communication issue between Boris Johnson and Joe Biden over the use of the word kerfuffle. The Prime Minister used it to refer to the impeachment over the Capitol Hill attack, whilst President Biden thought kerfuffle was the UK opposition leader.
Salutations, subjects. It gives one great pleasure to speak to you today in order to herald an exciting new arrival. Yes, there's a new batch of Charles and Camilla wedding plates on sale in the Windsor Castle gift shop. But be quick, folks, they're departing like hot cakes. Also, oh yes, there's a new royal baby due later in the year. I'm sure you'll all join me in congratulating the Wallace Simpson strumpet at, I mean, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex. Equally, one is thrilled at the possibility of the child being born as an USA, please consider this a payoff for the great historical debt we owe you in taking James Corden off our hands. Now, hashtag sad news. Sadly, one cannot make the baby shower, whatever it is. One is going to be at Pizza Express Woking, and there is conclusive proof of that. But rest assured, one greatly looks forward to meeting Bobby Joe Ivanka Harry Windsor Jr. III, or whatever the poor little sod's name is going to be. Well, thanks you all, and may all your taxes go with me.
Sir William McPherson, who led the inquiry that concluded that the police were institutionally racist, died quietly last Sunday after slipping and falling down the stairs of his local police station.
Hello, my loves. It's me, your Auntie Vax, back again to help you solve your issues and clear up your consternations. Here's our first letter. Dear Auntie Vax, I've read about this tunnel they're wanting to build between Northern Ireland and Scotland. Oh, I'm afraid if they dig too deep, they'll dig right through the big flat disc that is our planet. I don't know what would happen if they did. Would we be sucked into the vacuum of space? Whenever I ask my husband, he just says, for God's sake, Jane, you need to calm down. You're not the woman I married anymore. Love. Lots of love. Love. Love the show. Yours, Frightened in Fraserburgh. Well... Frightened, I think you're overreacting a tad. There's no chance of the tunnel boring right through the flat earth. It's more likely to break through the hollow earth and anger the advanced subterranean species that dwell within the planet's interior. See, maybe their invasion of the surface might begin in Port Patrick, but who knows? Anyway, space isn't real. You're way off base with that one, love. Okay, so cheer up.
Oh, my old man's got COVID. He's got a hacky cough. We're all so sick of this virus, wish it would just bug off. It came to us from China, it started in a lab. But it's science that will save us, so get your COVID jab. It keeps the intensity, it really gets on your chest. Don't want to catch it in Sainsbury's, or from a quarantining guest. Now you was just the type of girl to save me getting flu. They vaccinated me against the COVID too. Waiting outside in a long cold queue, watching incessant jabbing. I wish I'd put on a vest. Jab it, 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 jab it. My old man said he liked Van Zandt, and he likes what balance has to say. Well, he ain't no slacker. The wife thinks he's lovely like a king alpaca. They go dilly or dally, as COVID they tally. Cause science is the only way to go.
Never been on.
I hope they've got the reins on that scruff bag. Boris and Hackman called his head low. Sleeves up above the brown, sleeves up above the brown.
A nice little vaccine you go. E-I-E-I-E-I-O. We all miss the puppet, so get yourself a jab. Sleeze up, then we'll have a knees up. Sleeze up, Mama Brown. Oh no, what a rotten bug. Inject me with that drug, cause Grandma needs a hug. Oh no, messed up track and trace. You can do one, sir, go to. You don't know where I've been. Go and get a vaccine, stick it in my eyeball. Or bump.
Watching Fox News with me, an anchor. King Philip of Englandshire has been admitted to hospital as a precautionary measure. So to see how the King is doing, let's go over to our Englandshire correspondent, Chad Vallée, in London Village. How's the King doing, Chad?
Hi, Anne. Great to be here, but I gotta correct you there. It's not King Philip, it's Prince Philip.
Oh, so it's the Queen's son?
No, Anne, it's her husband.
That's very confusing, Chad.
We completely agree, Anne. Apparently, it's not like Frozen, where there's a king and a queen. The queen is married to a prince, and is also known as the Duke of Edinburgh.
Isn't that in very big fish land?
No, Anne, it's not in Wales. It's little doggy land.
Oh, you mean Scottishire?
We think so, Anne, but our researchers are still clarifying all that.
So, is Prince Charles also the queen's husband?
No, Anne. Charles is the Queen's son. That's where the laws of Disney princesses actually hold true.
So Charles's wife is Princess Camilla?
No, Anne. She's the Duchess of Cornwall.
Cornwall? Who makes a wall out of corn?
It's not a wall, Anne. It's an unreachable magic land that's always 3 hours away. She's the Duchess of Cornwall because her husband is Duke of Cornwall.
I thought she was married to Prince Charles.
She is.
So are her children princes and princesses?
She doesn't have any children.
Isn't our Prince Harry her son?
No. Princess Diana is the mother of the Duke of Sussex.
I must apologize for Chad's language there.
No, Anne. Sussex. Sussex is a region of Englandshire famous for its peers, such as the peers of Blackpool and Brighton.
Oh, I know this one. Peers sits in the House of Lords, like that Piers Morgan.
Exactly, Anne. Peers sits in the Senate of Englandshire.
So, getting back to the Duke, why is he not a king?
Well, we think it's because Prince Philip is Greek.
So the Greek king can't be an English king because he's married an English queen?
Actually, Anne, she's German.
So could an American woman like me be queen?
Not a king chance, Anne. You'd look terrible on a stamp.
Well, thank you. That was Chad Vallée, who used to work for Fox News. You've been watching Fox News. I've been an anchor. Flunky, is it too late to take back the colonies? Hell.
Next, Doctor. Ah, yes, Mr. Byeckers-like. Now, which arm would you like it in? You choose, I'm feeling lucky. Hang on, lad. Let the dog see to rub it. What's in the syringe?
Oh, in our vaccines? Well, what we call the road out of lockdown. A dose of normality.
No, I mean, where does it come from?
Well, our vaccines are the Russian vaccine, Sputnik. You know, as in the satellite.
I know what Sputnik were. And you can forget it.
Now, there was a bloke down Balls Club who had a dose of that. He now not only drinks vodka, but he's got a penchant for furry hats. Now, listen to me. I only eat beef on a Sunday, drink beer out of a proper glass, and have a portrait of the Queen into the hallway. I want the good old British one.
But what about the Pfizer-BioNTech? That's very good.
That's Belgian bollocks. I didn't vote for Brexit to have some poncy European vaccine. You wouldn't expect Nigel Farage, God bless him, to have it, eh?
Well, I can see I'm banging my head against a brick wall. So, would you like the Oxford jab?
Well, ideally, I'd prefer it if it were made in Halifax or Leeds. Now, it may be made in some softy town down south, but if it's British, that's good enough for me. Now, get on with it, lad. I've got to worm the wife and take the dog to the shops.
Don't you mean the other way round?
You're not from round here, are you? Come on, lad, crack on.
Matt Hancock has denied handing out COVID-19 related contracts to his friends.
The Prime Minister defended his health secretary by confirming that as far as he knows, Matt Hancock doesn't have any friends.
Oh, Liz, is that you, sausage?
Oh, hello, Philippe. Still in here, then?
Just a bite.
Fair enough. Now, do you need anything? She once tried to pick a winner for the 2:30 at Kempton. One will take that as a no, then.
Liz?
Yes, Philippe?
I'm not long for this world.
Yes, you said that the last three times. Now, forgive one for not getting one's hopes up.
Before I go, I've got something I have to know before, you know.
One takes one's last overturned Land Rover to the brothel in the sky.
Liz, please, grant a dying man his final wish.
Ew. Yeah, the only thing one wants jabbing at my age is the second Pfizer BioNTech, thank you very much.
No, not that. It's just, well, it's a bite of the children. All the rumours, all those years about Andrew.
Well, really, I blame that Maxwell woman.
No, not that. No, I mean, all the offspring, you know. That was the handsome one, you know. He was always go-getting and all action man, all military bearing and manly.
Yes.
Well, whereas you look at Charles and Edward, and as for Anne, well, she's more put to the pedal. But, Liz, what I'm asking is, before I shuffle off this mortal coil, is Andrew really mine?
Oh, well, of course he is, Philippe. It's the others that aren't.
Much like that. Dear Antivax, with the news that the kids are going back to school, I feel very torn. Part of me is getting ready to pop the champagne. Save me a glass. But the other part is still very suspicious of what the schools are teaching our children. It's like Michael Gove said, they're teaching kids to be ashamed of their history and have too many liberal ideas. Ooh. I have done a lot of good work teaching my kids the truth using minion memes. Oh. I don't want all that good work undone. What do I do? Yours, Truther in Teesside. Well, it seems like you've done some great work there, Truther. My favourite memes always include a nice glass of wine and proof that the Queen is in fact a lizard person. It's totally understandable to be nervous of schools teaching nonsense and undoing all your good work. I mean, their science teaches us that the Earth is in fact a globe. Their history teaches that Britain didn't create a doppelganger of Rudolf Hess so we could steal Nazi science. What a lot of nonsense. Having said that, I wouldn't trust Michael Gove either. I mean, you think a lizard person with that much money would be able to afford a more convincing human suit. Anyway, next up we've got our brand new book club segment and our producer will be joining me to discuss his newly finished 800-page manifesto. Join us after the break.
Dolly Parton has said, given the current circumstances, it's a bit much to create and erect a full-length statue of her in Nashville, Tennessee. So instead, they're just going to make a bust.
They closed it on everything, all shut down. They don't want anything. Go. If I sell beer, if I just sell beer, would you drink with me and we'll forget the world? I'm on furlough, I'd rather. It's been a year. SOS to number 10 on deaf ears. So let's all hold on. We hope it won't be too long before we have a big garden bursting into life. If I sell beer, I still intend to be here. So just hold on and I'll see you for that beer.
Flunky, is that going to be shown on OneTube? Yeah, one thanks you.